With a total of 757 exhibitors and over 30,000 trade visitors from all over the world, Aero 2019 at Friedrichshafen, Germany was a huge success.
Hi everyone, welcome to this episode of ForFunFlyer. Today I'm at Aero Expo at Friedrichshafen, Germany. One of the largest expos in the world, I guess. And in a two episodes series, I'm trying to document everything that is going on this expo regarding light sports aviation and microlight aviation. So join me on this two episodes series to find out what this expo is all about.
I considered to attend Aero Friedrichshafen Germany for years, but never found the time to visit this four-day exhibition. But it changed when a couple of friends convinced me to go and invited me to tag along. This wasn't only a nice opportunity to check out the latest on my flying hobby, but also to document this expo for you guys. Well, at least to try to document it, because there's just too much to share it all. So I picked a total of 6 exhibitors and asked them to share their stories with me. The first episode of a two-episode series covers 3 very impressive light sports airplanes, and consider those to be my personal favorites. The first talk I had was with the Dutch representative of Blackshape, builders of the fast and capable models Prime and Gabriel.
My name is Eddie Duisen. I'm at Lelystad Airport with the company ZelfVliegen. We operate about 20 planes from that airfield, and our great pride is of course the Blackshape Prime, which we have already 8 of them in Holland, and we use them for schooling and training and etc. etc.
Okay. Can you tell us a bit about the company behind the Blackshape Prime? How did they originate? Or
yes, Blackshape Prime also is actually a big company. They do satellite and trains, and there are 3,500 people working at Blackshape.
Okay.
It's called Angelo Investments. And Angelo Investments bought 10 years back the rights to build this plane from Millennium. So that's the first step we did 8 years ago, and from there we grow into one of the biggest airplane manufacturers in Europe. We are selling about 45 planes a year now, and the orders are going so fast that we have, for example, on the Gabriel delivery times of more than a year. The Blackshape is still going well because that's a standing line.
Right.
It means that we can deliver Blackshapes at 3 months at this moment.
Okay, yeah. So the Blackshape Prime was actually the first aircraft the company produced?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
Of course. Before that, it was only train, railways and satellites.
Okay, I see. Okay. So what is the main market for the Blackshape Prime? Because it looks like a really sophisticated airplane to me, which scares a bit.
For the average Joe
Microlight pilot.
But I understand completely, but no, it's really made for any pilot. Any ultralight pilot who wants to fly this machine is able to fly it. Of course, you have to train on a complex airplane. But if we take students for ultralights in Holland, we start with the Blackshape Prime. So from day one, they fly on this machine and get their training on this machine, fly their solo, and they have an ultralight license. So it's possible.
So in the lower speed regime, the Blackshape Prime just handles like any other microlight.
Yes, of course.
Well, you have got the retracts, of course, retractable landing gear.
It's faster. You have to think a little bit more ahead. As I mentioned, when you enter the circuit, you already reduce the speeds because otherwise it's impossible to
bleed
to get
off
the speed of on final. But if you get used to that from the beginning, it's no problem.
Okay.
And the most of the people who come with us and they have a license, ultralight license, we take them up, let's say, 3 hours to give them a conversion to this machine, and then it's done.
So that's a maximum amount of time, or is it just on average?
It's average 3 hours.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
But it also took me 3 hours to make an F-16 pilot fly on this machine.
Okay. So the background doesn't really matter.
No. You have to learn to know this machine, the layout, the way it works. It's very easy to handle. It's very easy to land.
Okay.
You have to do your things. You have to know the plane before you take it.
Yeah. So about the engine and the performance, it's a Rotex 100?
It's a 100 US, yeah, because we don't want to scale up too quickly. We are preparing the 140 horsepower, of course, but until now we had this weight problem.
Oh yeah,
we have the weight problem in Holland, in Germany. And luckily it's solved because Germany goes to 600. This plane is already done on 600. Mm-hmm. So I hopefully Holland will come also, yeah, and then the rest of Europe will follow.
Okay, so and the speed, what are the maximum cruising speeds, etc.?
Cruising speed, economically cruising speed is 145, 145 knots.
Knots, yes. It's almost twice as fast as my
phone. Yeah. We operated in the area mostly at 135, 140. Maximum cruise speed will be 160.
But it was interesting for me, at least, to see that Blackshape is also building other aircraft, because I thought, well, they make this aircraft, but Blackshape is more active than just the Prime.
No, they're actually, if you look further ahead, their goal in the future will be military aircraft, military trainers. And that's a much bigger market than this. This is a very small market.
Specific market.
Yeah, private owner who flies around, wants to have a lot of fun, wants to be very comfortable. You can fly about 1,200 kilometers non-stop with this machine. Oh. So I can fly from Holland to Friedrichshafen, back to Holland on one load of benzene.
That's insane.
It's amazing. It's really an amazing machine. Yeah. Please, if people are interested, we are always willing to give a demo flight. You can come to Lelystad, and at a restricted price, we can take you up just to have the feeling for yourself.
Okay. Well, sir, I won't hold you up anymore. Thank you for your time and this interview. And,
yeah, thank you for interesting.
Yeah, now there's interesting enough. So, well, thanks a lot.
Okay, thank you.
Picking beautiful and capable light sport airplanes to share on my channel, the following one definitely belongs in this episode. It's the newest LSA from one of my favorite airplane builders, Tecnam.
Yes, I'm Stefano Maviglio of Tecnam Aircraft Company. I am in charge of marketing and communication. I'm also the company historian, because not many people know that Tecnam is in aviation business since 1948.
1948, so okay.
So we have a long history, and today we are at Aero presenting new models. So also we are celebrating our 70 years in aviation.
Okay, wow. So I think not everybody knows exactly, but Tecnam doesn't produce only light sport aviation aircraft, right? So you have a really broad spectrum of airplanes, right?
Yes, we are in the top three general aviation manufacturer.
Okay.
So we have very broad line of aircraft. We go from the two-seaters, light, microlight, up to our latest traveler, P2012, that is 11-seater aircraft.
So can you tell us a bit about the latest in light sports aviation? So where we're standing right?
Yeah, we're talking about the P92 Mark II, and this is an example of our history and future connects.
Okay.
Because this is a model that, to say the name, was designed in 1992.
Okay, yeah.
So it's 27 years in flying worldwide, and probably this is one of our best sellers, more than 2,500 built in 27 years.
Yeah.
And today in Aero we present the latest edition, the Mark II,
that integrates
the composite fuselage
and
metal wing, metal stabilator.
Okay.
With full state-of-art next-generation avionics, glass G3X from Garmin. So it's a very beautiful aircraft. And with the composite, we innovate the old P92, increasing the width of the cabin. So it's much more roomy, much more space.
Okay.
And I invite you all the pilots to have a test, have a demo, and fly it.
This transition to the composite fuselage, that's a real big step, right? Because
it's not the first composite aircraft we make.
No,
we started with 2008. Also, we have a UL for the P2008 with composite.
Okay.
Then also on our four-seater, P2010 is a composite fuselage. We only made fuselage in composite. It's our design philosophy, because we know that in hangar operation, wings can be damaged, and to repair the metal is much easier than composite. So we only make the fuselage composites.
Okay, I see.
The landing gear is fully metal because we know that we have lots of students that not always are soft in landing.
Exactly.
We want to solve in advance future problems. We think also the future maintenance in design in this way.
Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Yeah. Can we have a peek inside in inside the airplane?
Yeah, of course.
So we're inside the new P92.
P92 Echo MkII.
Okay.
The version you we are sitting in is with the glass cockpit from Garmin, the G3X.
Okay, ah, nice.
It's beautiful because it has a synthetic vision, all the features for graphics and landing, and also we have the comb now here. The central throttle quadrant is not like this anymore, it's more fancy.
Okay.
And also the design, we took inspiration from our 11-seater, so a bigger aircraft. So it looks, it's a ultralight, but you feel like to be in a real big aircraft in some way. Tecnam made a big effort in the latest years also on interiors. You can see
it's dark, really spacious.
Yeah, dark interior. We have leather seats with Alcantara, double color. You will see in the back we have a leather pocket, Italian style, also nice. The good news for all the ultralight pilots that this aircraft can be also is ready for the new European law for 600 kilograms, the maximum takeoff weight. So you can have it in the board version, 472.5 kilos, up to 600 kilograms. We are looking at the glass G3X Garmin cockpit, but this also comes with a standard analog panel.
Oh, that's optional, or you could, the customers can choose what
can
they
choose from. Analog standard. Some they love analogs and they can have it, of course.
Well, what is noticeable, it's a really clean cockpit, right? So
yes, also all the experience we had from the bigger aircraft, we know now how to reduce the workload of a pilot. This one has a shorter wing, so it took the wing from our P92 Eaglet.
So is it faster too than then, or what are the speed ranges of this plane?
We are talking about max cruise speed of 115 knots.
Okay, that's solid. Okay. If people are interested in more information, obviously you have a website.
Yes, of course, www.tecnam.com.
Okay.
But also we have a Dutch dealer that is very...
Mr. Holman, right?
Yeah, Mr. Holman and Mrs. Ingrid. Right. They're very talented and competent. Yes. Yeah. They can help people and pilots in choosing the right aircraft.
Yeah. Well, thanks a lot for your interest and time. And
it was
a
pleasure.
Okay, thanks.
Ending the story of Tecnam's beautiful P92 Echo MkII, I would like to start with a third story of this episode. The one about a relatively new light sport airplane, the Blackwing from Sweden.
My name is Niklas Anderberg and I'm the designer of this Blackwing aircraft.
Beautiful, beautiful. It's really slick looking, so congratulations on
Thank you very much.
So can you tell us a bit about your company and the airplane?
Yes, we're based in Sweden and the company is 7 years old. This is our first airplane with a 915, which is a turbocharged engine. And we have the normal aspirated engine is the ULS 100 horsepower, which we have certified in Germany last summer.
Mm-hmm.
But now, of course, we're very excited to, with the new 600 kilo rules, to put in a bigger engine.
Okay.
We use modern materials and prepreg technology. So we have the slogan faster, stronger, lighter. So basically, we are one of the few airplane manufacturers that can put in this engine. And new for this year is the fancy lights on the winglets.
Yeah.
Also, of course, the engine installation, and we have also new panel layout we can look at later.
Okay, so and what are the performances of this airplane in regards to speed and etc.?
Oh, she has really good performance. We have a cruising speed of 150 to 160 knots. It's advanced 5,000 to 8,000 feet.
Okay.
And the winglets, she really likes to go up a little bit higher. So with the fixed gear, she cruises around 135 knots.
Okay.
The retractable 15 knots faster.
Okay.
And fixed gear wants to be around 3,000 to 4,000 feet, and the faster she goes, the higher she wants to go. So this probably wants to go at 12,000 feet. This is airplane number 7.
Oh, 7, okay.
Yes, and we have now also 10 planes in the production. We are planning to deliver those 10 planes this year, and probably 11 and 12 also.
Okay.
And they will be delivered with a ULS engine, which we have the Camelot for. And this airplane here will earliest start deliveries next summer.
Next summer, okay.
The first prototype I started developing 2001.
Okay.
And then a lot of people liked it. It was finished 8 years later. A lot of people liked it, and that's how we started Blackwing. And in the beginning, we financed the whole development. 2015 was the first time we took in outside money, and then it became like a real serious business. So,
okay.
I'm happy that we made it this far.
You earned a certain prize yesterday.
So yesterday night we won the Flieger Award, which is the Reader's Award. It's 9 nominated airplanes, and we were one of the nominees. And I'm super happy that we were the one that the readers chose to be the best autolite aircraft 2019.
Oh, well, congratulations.
Thank you very much. That's a big deal. Yes.
Because those are potential end users of the plane, so
yes.
that's what counts, right?
Exactly. Okay. And it's, of course, the customer is the best voters.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they're the honest ones, right? So, okay. So you'll be pretty busy in a short amount of time, I guess.
Yes, we're super busy to deliver the 5 planes that are in production. They're already painted, and also to be able to fly this machine and get her certified this summer.
Okay. So if people that are watching right now want to know more about your airplane or your company, what is the website address, URL?
Yeah, it's blackwing.aero. Aero.
Okay.
But we also do Facebook updates every week. So.
Okay. Obviously. Okay. Well. Well. Thanks a lot for your time.
Thank you very much.
Again, congratulations on yesterday. And,
thank you very much.
And hope to see future updates, and perhaps we can take it up in the air one time.
Definitely.
Okay. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thanks.
This episode isn't meant to be a comparison test between these 3 light sports aircraft, but simply to show you my personal favorite ones. However, I'm very curious about which one your favorite is and why. Let me know in the comments. Okay, that's it for this first episode of 2. Thank you for watching. Be sure to check out the next episode, covering the stories of Frans and Rotax, Sky Demon and UAvionics. And of course, check out the other videos in my channel too. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, please like and share this one with friends and family. Consider subscribing to my channel if you don't want to miss out on future episodes. And be sure to check out the website ForFunFlyer.com for the monthly contest and information about my channel. I hope to see you next time. Fly safe. Bye.